Guy Porter, so good to see you back in Australia, and congratulations on winning the first Ella Mobbs Trophy. How was that experience?
Yeah, well, thank you. It was a massive highlight. I mean, unexpected from the get-go, but to be back here playing tourist and amongst some old friends as well was pretty special.
Did you expect to make a debut for England in Australia?
No, I couldn't have scripted it, really. It was all a bit different, but I enjoyed it a lot.
Lads, someone that's made a massive impression in a short space of time since he's come here. Apparently he's already getting an English accent, so he's been practicing it. But yeah, mate, you settled in brilliantly, and the fight you've showed, not just out here today, but in training every day, is a credit to you, mate. Cap number 1447.
Eddie had a few special things to say.
The game, he was outstanding, mate. Worked hard, you know, he's that no-nonsense, bustling type Sydney Uni Centre, you know, they run hard, chase kicks, run hard, chase kicks, run hard, chase kicks, run hard, chase kicks. That's all Sydney Uni ever does. And he's out of that school. And he does that really well.
Was it scathing, or was it Eddie's very defined opinion on what Sydney Uni rugby's like?
Yeah, it was a bit different, wasn't it? No, I mean, I think there's plenty of truth to it.
Run hard and chase kicks is a lot of the mentality that I suppose I do play with, but it's what I learned here, and I mean that because, like, that sort of willingness to go again, repeat efforts, you know, whatever the flash it is, that's something I come up with. I learned here, and I know when you've got that ingrained in your club like you do, you're bound to go well.
So. What was your experience at Sydney Uni like?
Yeah, well, I joined when I finished school in 2014 to 15, and really enjoyed my time in Colts. Played not so much rugby. I was busted for 3 years there, basically. Didn't play a whole heap, but you know, got an awesome exposure to a great club, and really enjoyed the Shoot Shield. It was where I played with a group of really good mates who plenty are still at the club, and obviously plenty still chipping around in Super Rugby as well. So was part of a really ambitious group, and got some exposure to some great staff, and it was a really good experience, you know, on and off the field.
On field, Sydney Uni, the club that other clubs love to hate, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, there is that side to it for sure.
Why?
I think, you know, for a long time, obviously, Sydney Uni was the hunted through the early 2000s there, set a really high standard. And during my time, we had a bit of mixed success, but I think towards the back end, started to achieve some really good results. And of course, when you're in that position, yeah, you're going to attract some people trying to bite at your tail.
Special bunch of blokes. What's the camaraderie like?
Really good, and I think that's been such a highlight about being back over this period, is reconnecting with guys and coming into the club and then at the game on the weekend, having, you know, a few Sydney Uni pockets around, you know, wishing me well and hoping England lose. So.
Blokes over there just don't understand that this sort of place can exist. They're championship level or premiership level or whatever it is, they're in academy systems and professional sales for a long time, but they find it hard to comprehend that a high performance environment like this, where people turn up after working, after studying, whatever it is, and for however many years turn up to a place like this to work for one another and do it at such a high standard that when super guys come in or they consider professional players, it's like you're part of the fabric. So I miss a lot about this place. I'm living with Harry Potter, another uni boy at the moment, who watch the game every week. On a Saturday, and it means a lot to be able to keep track of what you guys are doing.
And tell us your pathway through after Sydney Uni through to what you're doing in England.
Yeah, I went at the end of 2019 down to the Brumbies and spent sort of 6 or 7 months there through COVID, which was, you know, for everyone a different sort of experience and had its own challenges. But during the season having stopped, the opportunity came up to go to Leicester. Rob Taylor had just gone over, Harry Potter had just gone over, so there was that sort of attraction. I guess knowing potentially those guys made it an easier move mid-COVID. Figured it was going to be a good opportunity to go and play plenty of rugby. I think there was more certainty at that point what was going on in the Premiership than there was in Super, and it was something I was always keen to do, to go back, so just went for it.
And here's the run from Porter, real strength, oh my goodness, he has Supermaned his way over. Guy Porter, is there anything you can't do?
And how did the England call-up come about?
Well, totally unexpectedly, to be honest. It was we finished our grand final at Twickenham, and having won, had a few guys from uni over and my family, and we were just celebrating the win, and then had a message from the team manager to say it was going to be announced on the Monday. So having not been involved in any of the camps or had any communication prior to that, it was a genuine surprise. And quickly had to pack a bag amongst celebrating, and then I was on the flight, you know, within 48 hours. So, very quickly.
You don't wish you were a wallaby?
No, I mean, I think I've made my bed now. So, I'm pretty comfortable, and I've enjoyed playing a lot in England. I think the Premiership's a great competition, and particularly being at Tigers, I feel like, if Sydney's home, then that's home away from home. So, until I'm back to the birthplace, that's I think where I'll be at.
Well, everyone in the crowd here watching you at the lunch is super warm, full of good spirits. You got anything you'd like to say to them?
No, I'm sure. I've been to quite a few finals lunches, and unfortunately usually playing the following day, so I'm gutted not to be there in person, but we wish everyone all the best and hope for a successful day.
Great to chat. Thank you so much for joining us.
No, thank you.